Hello guys, welcome to ShutterTux. Today we are going to discuss about a problem which almost all photographers have faced at least once in their lifetime: to get sharp images. So how come an image is known to be sharp? It can be due to a good lens. The Canon L series of lens offer superior sharpness, but for most of the times you can get sharp results even on a normal lens. But how to achieve maximum sharpness out of your setup? Of course, shutter speed and other stuff do matter when you are after sharp images. But a very crucial thing is often not looked by photographers: the technique of proper hand-holding the camera and a few bonus techniques. So the first technique, which I am sure you must have never cared about in your lifetime, is how to hold the DSLR properly. So my technique is perhaps a bit different to most of them, but I'll show you. So I do not take the camera strap in my neck, but I prefer to wrap the camera strap around my arm twice, and so it becomes really tight. And then I grip the camera. My left hand is down the lens as my right hand grips the DSLR grip, and that's how I hold the camera. And I hold it close to my body. And if you have noticed me, my elbows are tucked in. I'm not shooting like this, or I'm just being very calm, relaxed, and my elbows are right in. This gives me additional flexibility. Even at low shutter speed, my body is not moving. And since my elbows are all the way inside, the camera is not prone to shake. Most of the pictures which are not sharp are due to two factors. One is the subject motion, and the second one is the motion of the camera or the motion of the photographer. We can't correct the shake which occurs due to subject motion, but we can indeed correct the shake which is the part of the photographer or the camera. So here the technique of holding the camera is very crucial. So you should hold the camera with your elbows tucked in and body relaxed. Do not hold it very rigid, or you are bound to shake the camera. And you will ask, "Gaurav, all this is fine. You can click a fairly good photograph, a horizontal oriented photograph, with this technique. But what about the vertical orientation? If I tilt the camera vertically, you may notice my elbow is out now. So in that case, how will the stability come?" Yes, there is a trade-off. When you are holding the camera vertically, your elbow will come out naturally, and you can't click it like this. Your body will shake because it's not natural. So in this case, I recommend you to get a battery grip for your camera. A battery grip is a grip which attaches to the tripod mount of your camera, and it will provide you with an additional shutter release button. And in that case, the shutter release button is useful to click vertically oriented photographs. So if, let's assume, you have the camera grip with you and you have attached it to your camera vertically. So in that case, as you are taking vertical photographs, you will simply tilt the camera vertically. And now, since the grip is attached to the camera, it will protrude from the bottom and it will have a shutter release button here. So you will click it somewhat like this. And now, did you realize my both elbows are tucked into body, and I am again at the same position which I discussed before, with the elbows tucked into body, shoulders relaxed, and you can click it with the shutter release button on the battery grip. Fairly easy. The next tip I want to tell you is, if you have difficulty standing, you can perhaps take the help of the ground on which you are standing. You can slightly lower down the camera and you can come on the knee. And that's right, once you come on the knee, you can place your elbow on top of your other knee, and then you can hold the camera with that grip. And this will provide you with additional support, and the camera won't be shaky when you are taking those low angle shots which require you to go down. And before I closing, I want to tell you one more tip or a technique which can help you in situations where hand holding the camera properly ain't doing you good, or you have already tried the other technique which I mentioned. So in that case, you should look for a firm support like this tree branch. and you should lean on the support. You should lean your body weight on the support like this. And now you are in a good position to click without your camera being affected or being shaken, and you will get good sharp images for sure. So to sum it up nicely, first thing, you should know how to grip the camera properly, and you should learn these techniques. I know these techniques won't come to you because you have been using the camera the wrong way, but do practice, and with practice it will become second nature. Like as of now, I have my camera in my hand and it's very nicely gripped in my right hand. And the second technique which I mentioned of the support, of taking support of something which is solid in nature. And that's all for today, guys. I hope you learned a lot from this, and I will see you in the next video. Till then, take care.